this functionality with my other one. And so today's video is the ASMR tag that has been floating around YouTube, and I was tagged by the Crooked Kingo ASMR. Thank you so much for the tag. I always love these sort of tag videos, and I'm really excited to participate. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first time that I experienced ASMR was when I was a kid, and I was going to regular checkup appointments at my doctor. There was something just so wonderful about the methodical way that my doctor would go through all of the different testings that she needed to do. She managed to make what was just like a regular doctor's appointment testing different parts of me to make sure that everything was working alright. She managed to make it feel relaxing, which, telling from the way that my doctors nowadays do it, was something really special and rare. And I think that was really important, especially as a child, to have a doctor that was that good at what she did, because she made it such that I wasn't afraid of going. In fact, I started to really enjoy going because of the ASMR factor. Of course, I didn't have the words for it at the time, but that's what I was experiencing. As for the first time that I watched ASMR on YouTube, it's a little bit hard to tell because I definitely didn't record like the fact that I experienced this anywhere, but I estimate that it was sometime around the summer of 2013. I was just browsing YouTube on my laptop. Back then I didn't have a smartphone. I was browsing YouTube on my laptop and trying to find something that would help me sleep. I think I was looking up ambient, some sort of thing like that. And somehow I ended up on ASMR videos. Probably the first one that I really watched all the way through was in a roleplay by Heather Feather. And it wouldn't surprise me if it was a medical one, because that's what I was already familiar with. It would be really easy to convince me to keep watching if she managed to emulate the wonderful way that my old doctor used to make me feel. And basically in the approximate 5 years since, I've been listening to ASMR videos at night almost every night. Eventually I did get a smartphone, so I don't have to have my entire laptop out to listen to it, which is good because I'm pretty sure that's pretty bad for your laptop. Number three, what is my favorite unintentional ASMR video? There's not any particular one that I know of. I think that my favorite genre of unintentional ASMR is any sort of one where the person who is doing the ASMR is doing some sort of craft that they're really comfortable with. Like an experienced tailor doing the measurements for whatever they're making, the suit, the dress, whatever. It's like, for the person experiencing the measurement, perhaps it's a little bit of a rare and maybe a slightly uncomfortable experience, but when you have somebody doing the measurements who is like, this is my craft, this is what I know, this is what I've studied for many years, it's almost like the fact that they find this so mundane and usual and regular, and the methodical way that they go through it makes it feel almost comforting, like, don't worry, I've got you, I know what I'm doing. So basically any sort of really I know my craft sort of unintentional ASMR, that's my thing. And the last four ASMRtists I've watched, so I don't know if I've said it blatantly, but the ASMR that I watch is almost exclusively at night when I'm trying to go to sleep. And last night I watched the Crooked Kingo's roleplay, where I'll link it in the description below, but she was acting as this shopkeeper who was delicately and methodically packing these herbs and measuring it out and stuff, and that was really wonderful. I think that the way that she crafts her roleplays and the sets and the premises and everything falls so in line with the stuff that I love, which feels almost really rare to find something that aligns that perfectly. So I'm so glad that I was able to find her channel and start watching her does an incredible job of just bringing in you into every scenario that she does a roleplay for. She does mostly modern day, I think, and it's like when you watch her videos, it's choosing what relaxing moment of real life you want to be in. Like, the night before last, when I was watching her video, I was like, you know what? Tonight, I feel like taking a really relaxing international flight, which doesn't sound quite right because who likes international flights? But she managed to do it perfectly, and she really brought me into the world when she was doing it. Her role plays and her acting are impeccable. And the third one, who was a couple of nights before that, was GB ASMR. For about the 300th time, I watched one of her Azula role plays. Like, perhaps it's a really weird thing to compliment her on, but her soft speaking voice, it's so perfect. It's something that I struggle with, soft speaking as opposed to whispering, because I feel like I can't quite control my volume the way I want to. So, like, the perfect way that she measures her voice and the perfect acting that goes along with it, it's so good. There are so many reasons to like the videos that GB makes, but, like, I think I keep returning for the perfect way that she measures her voice, because soft speaking is one of my favorite triggers. And before that, it was Goodnight Moon. Goodnight Moon is incredible. She was definitely 100% one of the YouTubers that inspired me to create my own channel. The way that she brings you into her fantasy world, Babblebrook, is perfect. Like, watching her videos, to me, almost feels like returning to a dream world. Like, if you ever had one of those dreams where everything was perfect, the world came together in this wonderful way, and you had these cool imaginary friends there that made you feel so welcome and warm and happy, and then you woke up and you're like, gosh, I really want to go back. That's what every single one of her videos makes me feel like. It's like returning to this old, different home that you created, where everyone is there ready to welcome you back. It's beautiful, and someday I hope that I can create a world that's incredibly welcoming and full and happy and beautiful as Babblebrook. And before that, I watched Ephemeral Rift, of course. So Ephemeral Rift is someone that I think that I watched for basically the entirety of 2014. What else can I say besides the fact that, like, he is absolutely legendary for how well he creates the world that he creates. My goodness, like, he manages to make existential horror kind of cool, if that makes any sense. I think that I watch a ton of his Corvus videos, especially the beaking ones, and I'm so glad that he came up with another one recently. Like, so simple but so perfect. I love all of his role plays. Okay, so number five, what is my favorite ASMR trigger to listen to? My favorite one to listen to is probably soft speaking, and oh my goodness, I cannot do it for the life of me. I think that I can't quite measure my volume correctly on a day-to-day basis. I think I talk too loud, so if I whisper, then I feel like I have some level of control with my pacing, sort of, and my volume, sort of. But when it comes to soft speaking, I just completely, like, oh no, I've done such a terribly difficult job, and I've done it so badly, I can't control my voice at all, and I can't make it pleasant to listen to. And number six, what is my least favorite trigger to listen to? My least favorite trigger is probably listening to people drink things. And I knew this question was coming, so I did save some of my coffee from earlier, so I am going to do the drinking, but I am plugged into my microphone, so I guess this This will be interesting to listen to. Here we go. Seven, do I use ASMR to relax or fall asleep? I unintentionally answered this earlier. I absolutely 100% use it to fall asleep. I think I very, very rarely use it outside of sleep purposes. Very occasionally for studying purposes, but I think that it gets a little bit distracting to me somehow, even though it's supposed to just be background noise. Like, it still brings me out a little bit too much of focusing on anything because it makes me want to go into my trance state, basically. Number 8, what is my bedtime routine? I do not have one. I definitely want to have one at some point, but oh my goodness, I'm such a mess about that. I do all the things you're not supposed to do. I read in bed, I have lights on, I eat right before bed, that sort of thing. I'd say that my bedtime whatever I was doing before I was going to bed, bring it into bed, like reading, writing, watching YouTube videos that aren't ASMR, that sort of thing, bring it into bed, lay there for like 2 hours wondering why I'm not falling asleep, and then eventually put on an ASMR video and try to go lights out and go to sleep that way. Originally, I fell asleep with all the lights on because I'm a heathen. Semi-recently, I was like, you know what I really love? Candles. You know what I can't have at night? Real candles. So I got lots of fake candles. And this has also helped me with my YouTube videos because here I am trying to maneuver with a bunch of materials and not knock over the things that are flammable. So I have had one video come out that I had fake candles in, which was my Dark Town Clinic one. And there's this other one that I haven't released, which is part of a series that I do eventually want to release when I can record it with better quality and everything. Now that I have my mic, I can, but I think in the video I keep knocking over the candles, and in character I'm just like, wow, it is such a fortunate thing that I have these magic flameless candles to explain why, you know, I'm not setting everything on fire when I knock them over. That was a really roundabout way to answer that question. My favorite trigger to do. Crinkling stuff, especially parchment. I have a prop from aforementioned video that I haven't released, and this prop is a bunch of soaps packaged in a little parchment bag, and I am going to crinkle it as gently as I can because my gain is super high right now. what are supposed to be somewhat unintentional mouth sounds. Like, I wouldn't say perhaps unintentional is the wrong way to put it. By unintentional, I more so mean unthinking. Like, here I am doing this task and I just made this mouth sound. This is something that I'm doing because I'm thinking. Like, works is I feel like I am not fully aware or even half aware of all the things that I could do with it, but I just often have such trouble just getting everything to line up correctly that I haven't really explored the more interesting parts of video editing. Now that I have a better mic and I can see a little bit more potential with my videos that way, I'll get a little bit more adventurous, but I guess we'll see. 15, what time of day do you film? Oh my god, like, isn't this the question? I feel like so much of my recording related issues are the fact that I record midday, and I know I'm super not supposed to do that. I know everyone that I talk to and that I listen to about the issues of recording is always like, record super late at night or record super early in the day. And I never ever do it because I don't know. When I wake up super early or when I go to sleep super late, it's usually because I'm already doing something that's really important that needs to be handled, and when I'm done with that, I want to go the heck to sleep. So I don't quite follow the rules of recording super early or super late, and that definitely causes me some troubles with getting the takes all right, because I have to worry about background noise. So who knows? Now that I plan to record more roleplays, I think that I'm going to try doing it late at night and see how that works out. I did record the Dark Town Clinic one super late at night, which is also why the lighting was so crappy, because I didn't have anything to really light my room quite right. So, learning experience. Maybe I'll start doing what I'm supposed to. Number 16, what is my favorite video that I've made? Oh boy, can I look at my own videos right now? Because I don't really know. I think that a lot of them I feel semi-neutral towards, because I see a lot of potential that I'm not really delving into quite as much as I wish I could. At least for me, when I am making my videos and editing my videos, mostly what I look at is like, oh, this is the thing that I need to do better. I'm very critical of my own work, which I think is definitely super, super common. Everybody sees the mistakes they made and the things that they want to improve. So, unfortunately, that's mostly the way that I look at my own work. But, let's see. Of the videos that I made, what do I like the most? I think possibly it's the dwarf and beard trim one. It's such a simple one, just one that I popped out, like, and had so much trouble with. That's one of the ones that I couldn't quite get to work right, and yet it ended up being my favorite, because maybe it was the fact that, like, it was the best sound quality that I think I had captured at that point in time. And now that I have this new mic, maybe I'll be able to capture things as good as I had in that video. So maybe I'll be able to answer that question a little bit more clearly in the future. At this point in time, it's aspirational rather than settling on one that I'm like, oh, okay, of the ones I have, this is my favorite. Number 17, have one of your videos had an unexpected negative fan reaction? Not really, no. There was this one video, the beard video actually, where I posted it on the ASMR Reddit, and somebody was upset with me because I had tagged it incorrectly, and that's a very valid thing to be upset about. But I think I was really bummed at the time, because I was like, oh, look at this new video that I'm super excited about. And then I tagged it incorrectly, and then the first comment on it was something being mad at me, so that was basically it. Number 18, what videos of yours do you think didn't get the love it deserved? Jeez, I don't know. I don't think that I have any particular expectations for what my videos deserve, unfortunately. In terms of, like, just plain viewing, I'm kind of surprised at, like, how little views there are for my ASMR reading of A Modest Proposal. Maybe it's the fact that people don't really know what I'm referring to when I'm reading that. But, like, it has much, much less views than the videos surrounding it. So I'm surprised that that's especially as a one-off reading. Like, if it's a series, I would expect that less people would listen to it, but apparently that's not the case. 19. What does the audience not know about the behind the scenes of your channel? I don't know, really. I really don't know what could possibly be so surprising about what I do. I think, before, I vaguely mentioned that I was only using my phone for my mic, and I was using, for a very short while, only my camera mic, and my camera mic is actually the one that I use for the dwarf and beard trim, so I don't know if that's surprising, that the one that the sound quality I kind of liked was with just my regular camera mic, but I never managed to get the quality quite how I wanted it after that. Maybe the sounds were just sharp enough to pick up, but I guess perhaps the surprising part would be the fact that so much of my stuff is just cobbled together. I think it seems a little bit arrogant to say that people can't tell that, maybe, because I can definitely tell when I look at my videos that they're not quite set up the way that I wish they did. Number 20, what's the most absurd request you receive from a fan? I don't really have any absurd requests. I think that I've only actually had one request so far, and it was just basically, well, how do you feel about doing a reading of this type in the future? And I was like, oh, that's actually a super good idea. So no absurd fan requests so far, just very simple, very, oh, I completely agree, that's a great idea sort of requests. And number 21, do your family and friends know you make ASMR videos? Some of my friends do. Some of my friends have directly talked about it too. I've mentioned, oh shoot, these are the troubles that I'm having when recording my ASMR videos. And to another, I was like, oh, I'm making a new channel. These are the struggles I'm having. My friendships are very much like, let's talk about our daily experiences and just like vent and let it out. And it's very cathartic. It's very fun. I actually have a lot of fun having that sort of conversation with my friends, like just hearing them say, oh man, you can't believe what would happen to me today. So it's kind of in the vein of, oh, you never know what happened when I was recording this video today. It was quite a conversation when I kept losing my audio, like, oh my god, I am so mad. Listen to all of this horrible stuff. As for family, they know that I record things because I'm like, oh, try to give me my alone time during these hours because I'm going to be recording something and I can't answer the phone, that sort of thing. Basically, they know I make videos. They don't necessarily know that it's ASMR. And number 22, have you ever been recognized in public? No, and I don't think I'm big enough for that sort of thing yet. Although, if I managed to get recognized in public, I don't know how I would react. Probably flattered, probably really uncomfortable, because at least at this point, I haven't really shown my face on this channel, so I think that would be a little weird if they could manage to pick me out from, like, some tiny detail. What inspires your video ideas? I think that a lot of them are roleplay-wise, things that I would love to see in, like, a interactive format. Like, I play a lot of choice-based games, I play a lot of roleplay games, that sort of thing. So I would love to see more interactive ones in the world of fantasy. Like, oh my god, I'm so typical. I am very, very into fantasy stuff and historical fiction type stuff. And I haven't posted that many roleplays, but all of my roleplay thoughts so far for the series that I want to make are centered around the idea of playing a character who, in very typical fantasy fashion, is going to become the king. And these are all of your experiences leading up to it, just the very mundane things surrounding the actual adventure. So I think my love of fantasy, obviously, inspires a lot of things. And as for the readings, I'm very inspired by the fact that I just really love audiobooks. I think that they're a really great way to experience books while being able to multitask. I'm a big multitasker, so having the ability to read a book and do something else at the same time is very valuable to me. And having it in ASMR format. It just coincides with other stuff I enjoy. 24, where do I find myself spending the most time online? Reading articles. Like, not even necessarily very interesting, good articles, but just like, I read a lot of narratively, narratively.com, I think. It has a lot of memoirs and just stories about people talking about their experiences. Not even necessarily in a very newsworthy fashion, just listen to my story, let me tell you what my life has been like, let me tell you about this instance that I had. I find those very interesting. I love narratives, I love just learning stories from another person's point of view. So, that's where I spend most of my time online, trying to chase that sort of feeling. 25. What advice would you give someone who wanted to make their own ASMR content? Yourself as entirely as you can each time you make a video. My struggle with trying to get the right take and trying to record everything, like a lot of it could be lessened if I would just take the time to really set up my stuff, but I'm so raring to go and so ready to get into the actual meat of the experience that I make it a little bit more difficult for myself. So if you're anything like me in that way, like, really take your time to set up your stuff correctly. Have your mic in place, have your batteries all fully charged, clear your SD card, all of that stuff. Like, really prepare yourself. You know, the whole ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, that sort of thing, except with videos. So, I guess that concludes my advice, that concludes my tag. Thank you very much for the tag in this video, and man, I am so ready to do a roleplay. Hopefully I'll be able to get one out soon. I do have so many ideas, and if you watch this video, thank you very much. I will do some tags in the description bar